My name is Linda. I'm a nutritionist yogini, and today I'll be leading you through some exercises seated on a chair. This could be great if you have issues standing for an extended period of time, or if you just want to do some stretches from your seat, that works as well. This is also great for elders. So let's begin. All you need is a chair. So I recommend using a chair as opposed to a couch or a bed, just because it's a little firmer surface. You could also sit on a bench, that works as well. Something with a back might be nice, just in case. Safeties first, always wear shoes with a little grip on the bottom, so you have a firm grip of the floor. You don't want to be sliding around anywhere. And when you sit in your chair, make sure you're not slumping in your chair, but shift your weight, your hips forward, so that you are using your perineum, center of your pubis, to elevate yourself. All right, so let's move to the edge of the seat. Again, try to shift your weight forward. And notice when you are here that there's a right angle at your ankle, a right angle at your knee, and a right angle at your waist. Perfectly aligned. Let's take a few breaths. Taking a breath in through your nose. Imagine it going all the way to your belly button, reaching your diaphragm before exhaling back out through your nose. If this is not accessible to you, you can also breathe in and out through your mouth. Nice, easy, thin breaths. Feeling all four corners of your feet firmly planted on the ground. Feeling your hands gently resting on your lap. Feeling your sit bones firmly on the seat. If your eyes were closed, gently flutter your eyes open. Feel free to close your eyes when you're doing your breathing exercise, but you're also welcome to keep your eyes open or keep them about three quarters closed. What I like to call Tai Chi eyes. All right, so now we're going to do some warm-up breathing for our spine. So you're going to inhale, broaden your collarbones, open your chest, elongating the spine, and exhale, forming a little turtle shell with your spine. Inhale. I'm going to demonstrate from the side, but you stay seated on your chair and continue, just so you can have an idea of what my spine looks like when I inhale and exhale. Inhale, exhale. Your breath may be a little shorter than mine. That means your inhales and exhales are a little faster and your movements are a little faster. Or maybe you take a longer breath so your movements will be a lot slower. Just follow the natural course of your breath. Take three more together. And after your exhale, inhale to a neutral spine. And just observe, letting go of the breath, of the movements. some rotations. You keep your hands on your lap, or maybe hold onto the side of the chair. I think keeping on the left is a little easier. You're just going to rotate. Imagine hitting each corner. So getting into every nook and cranny in your hips. Feet firmly planted on the ground. You're holding on to the edge of the seat. That is fine as well. Imagine bringing your chest forward and back. Really getting your hips moving, your waist turning. You could do it slow, like churning butter. Or you can move it a little faster, like whipped cream. Now, switch opposite directions, clockwise, counterclockwise. We already went clockwise. Remember to maintain even breaths. Right now, we're warming up our bottom floor, the primitive nature. The bottom floor is ruled by survival, sex, money, food, and water. And relax. Finding your neutral seat. Observing your feet, how they're still firmly planted in the ground. Notice your hands are just gently resting on your lap. And how your sit bones are held by the seat. Now we're going to move on to the second floor, our capacity. You're going to put your hands on your shoulders, and you're going to inhale to the left, exhale to the right. So inhale to your heart space, exhale out to the world. In, out, in, out. You can take it slower, faster, whatever is comfortable for you. If this makes you dizzy, you can close your eyes. You know where you are. You know where your feet are planted. You know which direction is left. You know which direction is right. In, out, in, out. The left side is our heart. It is our lunar nature. It rules our emotions. The right side is the world, reaching out. Your right hand usually makes the deal, signs the contracts. We used to shake hands. In the middle is where you reconcile both sides. Press your palms together. If this is easy, you could press them back to back. If that is easy, maybe you could flip them. So, hands together, or back to back, or maybe flip them again, and your palms are touching, creating a vessel to encapsulate yourself. And from here, same thing. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Cleaning out all the way to the bottom of our lungs, exhaling out all that we don't need. Maybe you can move a little faster. Maybe slower. And then release. Place your hands, palms up on your lap. Letting it all go with a sigh. One more time, inhale to your belly. Exhale. One last time, inhale to your belly. And exhale. Now we're gonna do some tapping. We did some tapping last time as well. And what this is you're activating different parts of your body, bringing attention to different parts of yourself. You start at the crown. You can bring it down to the side, to your temples. This is a great place for stress relief. Bringing it behind your ears. Really getting in behind the jaw. Lots of people hold tension there. Tap, 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 tap. Side of your neck. Back of your neck. The bottom part of your brain. Front of the neck, your thyroid. Hear that vibration, tapping it up. Your collarbones, your shoulders. Now take one arm, tap it out. Your armpit. Armpits are important, cleaning out those lymph nodes. Other arm. Using your palm to tap, your fingers are just kind of following. And now, tap your chest. Tapping our lungs, waking up our lungs. You can even alternate. Our thymus, this is where our immunity lies. And now, bring it to your solar plexus. You can use your fingertips here. A lot of people are very sensitive around here. Rules are power. You even bring your thumbs together and do that. If that's too intense, you can switch back to fingertips. And now let's bring it down to below our belly button, our dan qin. This is where our energy is stored in our body. A pool of swirling energy. That's why it's important to clean it out. Keep it clean, like the hip rotations we did before. We do alternate. Feel the vibrations all over your body. Now let's bring out the hips. And maybe on your kidneys. Outside of your knees. Your kneecaps. So maybe you can bring it down on your legs. Tops of your feet. Backs of your knees. Back up. Back to our immunity. Alternate. And let it all out. Inhale. Make a big V for victory. Form little cups with your hands like you're catching the blessings from above. Inhale, take a deep breath. Hold it at the top. Take another sip of air. right arm underneath the left arm. So your elbows are stacked. You can bring your palms together, or you can have them back to back. Or if this is too difficult, you can grab opposite shoulder. And from here, inhale, and slowly start to hinge at your hip. Try to make contact with your belly and your thigh. And keep your gaze forward, vision forward. Keep your eyes looking up and sitting back up. And always know that you're firmly planted to your seat. Your legs are steady, sturdy, holding you in place. Coming up, really keep your vision up. You gotta look the direction you wanna go. Do some rotations, small circles backwards. Now small circles forwards. And relax. Now let's do the opposite elbow. So now let's do left elbow under right elbow. You can have hands back to back, or maybe your palms can touch each other, or you could just hold onto your shoulders. Inhale, and exhale, fold. Take a breath at the bottom. Now do some bigger circle backwards. You'd alternate arms. And now bring it forward. And relax. Now stick your right foot forward, plant your right heel on the ground, and hinge at the hips, extending your right hand towards your toes. Be careful not to curve your back. So, right angles, extending the heel out, and you're hinging at your hips like we did before, extending your hand. So you're not reaching for your toes. I want you to hinge your hips first. You keep your hands on your lap if that helps. And then meet your toes after. So hinge. And then see where your arm reaches. Heel on the ground, slowly hinge at the hips, and then reach your hand forward. That way you're using your legs. Because a lot of the times people try to bend over, you just bend over like this. Look at how much strain you put on your back. So this way, when I'm hinging, I'm completely in my legs. So my legs are doing the work. My upper body easily follows.
remember to take nice in and out breaths here. And then much slowly unhinge at the hip. All right. Now, let's take your right ankle and put it on your left knee. Make sure you're at the edge of your seat. You can hold on to the sides of the chair. I'm just going to take a few breaths here. This goes really deep in the hip, so you could keep your hand over here as well, making sure your foot is not floppy, but it's active. That helps protect your knee. And if anything feels like it is straining, imagine your breath going to that area, bringing your energy to that space. Relax, switch feet. Continuing with our deep belly breath. Now this is my favorite, side bends, side twists. So put your left hand on your right knee. You could grab the back of the chair for a nice twist. You grab the seat or the back of the chair, either works. Keeping your spine nice and tall, broadening at your collarbones, relaxing the shoulders. Feet still firmly planted in the ground. Imagine a golden thread elongating from the tip of your head to your tailbone. From the top of your head, it reaches up into the universe, and from your tailbone, it extends to the core of the earth. Straight line from the top of your head, down your spine to your tailbone. Remember to switch sides. Now, lift up your right knee, hug it to your chest. If you can't hug your knee to your chest, you just hold it wherever your knee goes, the closest you can bring it to your chest. And rotate your ankle both directions. Hold out the hamstring, rotate your knee both directions. Keeping your ankle as loose as possible. Switch sides, hug your left knee to your chest. And rotating at the ankle. Grab onto your hamstring, back of your thigh, and rotate your knee. Keeping your ankle joint loose as possible. Bring a nice little warm energy to your knees. Say, I love you, knees. Now, find your neutral seat. Now you're going to interlace your fingers behind your back. So your fingers are going to do this. Try to find the middle of your back. So I look like a little hanger here. Your thumbs are pointed up behind your shoulder blades. So like that.
If this is hard for you, you could just overlap your hands behind your back as well. That also works. But try to find that bind. And we're just going to end with some deep breaths. Inhale, exhale. Imagine your bird flapping your wings, flying over the trees, seeing what's out there. Maybe you could flap a little faster, like a hummingbird, going from flower to flower, checking out the pollen. Coordinating your breath with the flutters. And now slow down, like a bald eagle. Ever so majestic and noble. Chest. Thank you so much.